shift it up by 10 units. Because basically, the problem is our cluster of residuals is entirely wrong place. So what we want to do is move the residuals around. And the way we move the residuals around is by affecting the original line, by changing the original line so that it has a slightly different prediction. And that'll give the residuals, we want them closer to zero. As you were kind of saying, I think early on. So what we can do is look at those residuals and kind of run various counts on the residuals and say, oh, okay, so the average residual was a 10, so therefore our line should move up 10 units. But if it was negative, it would be down 10 units, whatever the units are. And then if the residuals were positively correlated with X, because remember, they're not supposed to be, right? They're not supposed to be correlated with X. So then we need to be, increase the slope of the line. So instead of being here, like, it needs to be more than there. So that tells us if there's a positive correlation with X, then our line needs to shift up. Does that make sense? And then for kind of the last example here, if the residuals were above zero in the middle and below zero on the left and right, then basically the short answer is this is telling us the problem is linear. The progression is not a linear choice. Okay? So this is kind of like the, let me just flip to the graphic. You're looking at like these residuals, right? So if it's an arc, that probably tells us it's not a linear regression. So, and then we had another one, and I think here, maybe, is this the residuals? No, it's the actual, this is the residuals. So, this, again, kind of, maybe not, maybe it's an arc there, so maybe that's not a good linear regression. So, I will definitely try to find a better example for next time. But this is kind of the idea, is that if the difference between, let me see if I can get back to this, so basically, if you kind of take these rules, and if they're not true, then they give you a hint about how to make them true. Does that make sense? So, in other words, we know that the average residual should be zero, right? But if it's not, then that tells us how far off we are as well. I'll find another example. We'll do it again, probably on Tuesday. And then here's just the same slide of the answer for him. So that gives you a hint. All right. So, long story short, that this is kind of all coming down to how can we quantify the correlation coefficient measures on a positive point or a positive framework? So, in other words, like the higher, you know, the closer we are to one, or the closer we are to negative one, is how tight our scatter plot will be around an individual line. So, maybe we can start to quantify that statement. And let's hopefully, my examples here are a little bit better than the last ones. So when we, yeah, so basically when we look at the standard deviation of those residuals, it helps us to say that we are